果能够通过冷静的观察和科学方法探索超自然现象的真相，无论是惊奇、害怕，或是对未知的好奇，这样的经历都能引导我们更深入地了解自身和周遭环境。一起来看看今天所发生的怪事吧。
Facebook 上有一位女士 ，Valstreet Louis 上传的奇怪的影片。这位女士在她家中居住了很多年，一直经历着一系列超自然现象，例如灯光闪烁和物体自行移动等事件。因此，她决定在房子四周安装了一些安全摄像机，希望捕捉到这些奇怪的事件。有一天，当他坐在沙发上看手机时，相机记录下了令人意外的一幕：一些植物突然移动，接着是一个物体从桌子上掉落，随后橱柜门自动打开，这让他感到惊慌，匆忙逃离了房间。他提到正在考虑搬离这个地方，除非有人知道如何清除这些超自然的存在。但许多网友疑惑，为何住了那么多年才决定搬离呢？这不是一开始遇到超自然事件就该做的决定吗？对此你怎么看呢？在这段神秘的影片中，一名男子选择在黑暗的夜晚带着他的狗前往树林中央露营，帐篷搭好，他上床入睡。然而，令人不安的声音打断了他的宁静。为了找出声音的来源，他决定调查，随即捕捉到一阵女人哭泣的声音，让他感到毛骨悚然。当男子试图环顾四周寻找声音的来源时，他发现声音似乎从树林中四面八方回响，使他难以辨别方向。更让他感到不安的是，他的狗开始对住某个远处的目标吠叫，揭示出黑暗中一个白色的人影。这场景让人感到诡谲，仿佛有一些不可知的存在在树林深处潜伏。类似的情境也在另一段视频中发生，一名叫灰熊加兹的人和他的狗同样在树林中露营。他们选择了一条1953年拆除的废弃铁路线旁的树林，帐篷搭好后，一切似乎安静。
Hello? Hello?
然而，当夜深时，加之被一阵惊悚的噪音惊醒，他寻找声音的来源，但最终无果。放弃后，他回到帐篷继续入睡，却再次被吵醒。
Hello?Hello? Hello? I'm off, mate. I'm off. Come on, mate.Stop messing about. Come here. Still hear it. Absolutely bobbed my pants then.
发现黑暗树林中有一双发光的眼睛注视着他，令他感到不安至极。这些令人毛骨悚然的露营经历让我们不禁思考，究竟树林深处隐藏着什么神秘的存在？这些营地遭遇者的故事似乎超越了一般露营的常态，带来了无法解释的惊奇和恐惧。或许在这片黑暗的树林中存在着超自然的现象，让人们不禁对未知的恐惧心生疑虑。TikTok 用户 Ski Boyardizer 上传了一部诡异视频。在大约11月底，一名学校的保安在值夜班期间，在校园里闲逛时，开始注意到一些不寻常的现象。当天色转暗时，许多其他员工都会避免这特定区域，并在一定时间后禁止学生在该区域附近徘徊。这所学校因建在墓地之上而闻名，而校内走廊上的旧墓地照片和墓碑更加添了一份诡异的氛围。一些清洁工曾经在这所学校工作，一致表示每天晚上都会发生一些奇怪且难以解释的事情。这位现任的清洁工也经历了一些让他感到毛骨悚然的现象，因此他决定记录下来。
Alright, I usually don't record while I'm on the job, but this is freaking me out. It's sort of unreal. Here at work, I'm here in the janitor's closet. Yeah, let me just show you guys. Alright.Just to, I don't know, let you guys know, this school was built on a cemetery. I don't know if that helps my situation or not, but previous janitors that have worked here have tried to tell everyone that, you know, every night something happens, some spooky shit, I don't know, paranormal or whatever you want to call it, but yeah, I didn't really believe them until tonight. Was in here cleaning up after some students had thrown a party, but what's been freaking me out is this one right here. No matter where I'm at in the classroom or what I decide to do, it just follows me. And do your thing, you stupid balloon. I got you on camera now, so let's just, see?That right there. Shit. Just...Ooh, okay. See, no. It just follows me no matter what.I can't.
在一间教室里，他注意到一组气球，其中一个气球似乎在移动，甚至在清洁工离开教室时跟随着他，令他感到不寒而栗。当清洁工沿住走廊撤离时，他突然看到一个黑影迅速地穿过走廊尽头，这让他吓得决定提前结束当晚的工作。
I'm back. Today's Saturday. You guys wanted to know about the video. I haven't come back here, haven't touched anything since last night, so I'm back to see if everything's still where I left it and see if those balloons are still there. I really don't want to be doing this, so I'm doing this for you guys. Yeah. Like I said, I haven't been back here to touch anything. I don't even know if you guys can see that. Yeah, I can't.
然而，第二天晚上，当他回来时，他惊觉红色气球就在黑暗的房间入口处等待，让他想起前一晚的恐怖经历，因此他决定不再进入。从那时起，这名清洁工便害怕独自上夜班。这连串的神秘事件不仅影响了他的工作，也在学校内营造出一股诡异的氛围，让人不禁怀疑学校是否真的受到了超自然力量的影响。或许这座学校的历史和地理位置使它成为了一个充满着不可思议事件的场所。大家是否还记得我们之前多次介绍过的 The Hooker YouTube 频道中的 Nick 呢？他不仅经历了许多超自然现象，甚至在之前的房子里捕捉到了影子人物。然而，即使搬到新房子，令人毛骨悚然的现象在几周后却再度回来困扰住他。为了解开这个谜，他在房子各处安装了安全摄像头，竟然意外地捕捉到了一些惊人的画面。
Babe. Hello? Babe? Max? Dude.Someone's in my closet. Weapon of some sort.Here.
Who's here? Hello?
Damn, man.
Max, come here. Max. Maxie boys, come on. Come on, Max. Max. Come on, Maxies. Come on. Come on, Maxies. Come on. Come on.
当他独自在家的浴室时，他听到了来自房间另一边衣柜的声音。于是他决定录影并检查。令人惊悚的画面显示，一只黑色的鞋子从衣柜伸了出来。更令人不安的是，在黑暗的衣柜里竟然出现了一张苍白的脸。他吓得立即逃到车库。他提到那里的任何东西都比他高，但衣柜里伸出的黑色鞋子却不是他的。在摄像机捕捉到这一幕后，由于手机电量耗尽，摄像机突然关闭。
It's not finished. No, it's not completely done. I did it.I don't know what I'm doing, so I burned it. I burned the lettering and shit. I made this out of redwood. It's got little foam pads on it. Is anybody in this room that would like to say hi, or talk to me, or tell me why you're here?Tell me why you've been tormenting me for like 3 years now. Maybe you're the one that I saw in Dire Lane that night. If you are, can you let me know you're here? Maybe tell me why you're here.Anybody? Is anybody in this room aside from me? I don't know how to use these things. I don't know if I'm using it right. I don't know if I'm supposed to wait. I don't know. Should I just lightly touch it? I'm assuming so I can not very easily slideable. Should probably.I guess it's the way it should be, right? I don't know. I can't, like... So... If somebody's here, please just say yes. Somebody say yes if you're here. If somebody's here, can you please...Move this triangle with the circle over to the yes. I don't think that I need to be touching it for any reason. I think that if you're present, you can move it yourself. I've seen you move things in my house many, many times. If you are present and you would like to talk to me, please move that triangle over to the yes.Oh, forgot one thing. Whoops. Goodbye, whoever might be in the room, and doesn't want to talk. Goodbye. Go back to where you were. Goodbye. It's like, whatever. Okay.
尽管 Nick 醒来，牧师清理房子，但他还是遭遇了类似超自然事件，情况并没有改善。于是他转向通灵板，试图联系房子中的尸体，但不仅未解决问题，反而让情况变得更加恶劣。虽然在通灵的会议期间并未发生特别的事情，
Shut up with that Ouija board.
但数周后，许多物体自行移动，其中一个场景中甚至出现了一个黑影人物，令人毛骨悚然。尽管尼克坦言他对编辑不在行，但一张令人毛骨悚然的照片竟然出现。
I came home from work, and this was on the floor in the living room.My wife picked these books up from some house that was giving away free shit. But when I picked it up, it automatically wanted to open to this page, like as if somebody looked at this page a lot or something. And I noticed these three burn lines in it. But look what's in the middle.
随后，他回家发现地板上的一本书，打开特定页面上的字烧焦，形成“地狱”一词，显示这个地方可能受到邪恶和恶魔的影响。更糟的是。当他查看原始文件时，他发现这实际上是一段他不记得的恐怖影片，显示有人正在黑暗中。尼克感到极度害怕，并强调他绝对没有拍摄过这段影片，也不知道他是如何出现在他的设备上的。观众甚至怀疑这可能是另一个实体在模仿他，甚至可能是更糟的情况。总的来说，尼克的处境变得越来越糟，而这些只是问题的冰山一角。下一个影片由用户 Gabriel Frazen 发布到流行的 Ghost Subreddit 上，他声称这段影片是由他妈妈的监控摄影机拍摄的，内容展示他的兄弟将一棵圣诞树放入汽车后备箱中，打算稍后将其开回家。然而，在这一过程中，摄影机捕捉到了一个不可否认的令人不寒而栗的场面。在影片中，一个令人毛骨悚然的苍白身影在背景的树木后面移动，然后在下降时慢慢消失。数秒后，当该名男子试图关上车门时，可以看到两只手一只接一只的从车底伸出，仿佛站在车门旁试图抓住他。这一瞬间确实令人毛骨悚然。然而，是否真的涉及到鬼魂仍然是一个未解之谜。影片中的场景虽然令人印象深刻，但也可能是光影或其他超自然现象所致。观众们在评估时应保持谨慎，不要轻信一切。这样的影片总是引发讨论和猜测，但真相仍有待进一步的检验和分析。你觉得这会是什么呢？
对于超自然现象，我们重要的是要以尊重和谨慎的态度面对，并寻求可能的科学解释。在探索未知的道路上，保持开放心灵，或许会揭示出更多意想不到的真相。今天影片就到这里，欢迎订阅天马行空，点击小铃铛，我们下一集再见。